Hello guys, this is your sister Jiyu and I'm here to talk about Blackpink today. So Blackpink released their new album, actually their new song like a couple of days ago, and it already hit 180 million views for 5 days. You know, that's incredible. I was really proud and kind of surprised to see how popular and how hit their song is, and I saw their music videos over and over again, and I listened to their song over and over again, like I guess at least 10 times each. I have something to talk about you guys about Blackpink's music video behind story and comment and reply about them in here in South Korea. Okay, so number one, YG stock market price surged, like literally surged. So before Blackpink released their new song, YG's stock market price was like this. But you know, like after they released this song, their stock market price like high up like this. You know, actually, there were some bad cases and bad accidents in YG last year, especially surrounding Big Bang, which is a really, really big hit group in YG. Anyways, that happened, so YG stock market price plunged. But this time, Blackpink almost re-survived YG stock market status, you know? So their market price was almost recovered as the price of right before the Big Bang accident last year. It's not actually Big Bang accident, it's a accident surrounding Seungmi especially. But anyways, Blackpink did a good job for their company as well. And I guess my guess and my assumptions after I talked with my Korean friends, the reason why Blackpink is so hot and so popular, especially nowadays, of course their song and their fashion style and their style and everything is so, so great. And plus that, like, people were really focused on how they will be good in the circumstance of YG situation, because they, YG, have gone through a lot of like bad cases since last year, and Blackpink was one and only hope in YG actually. So people were thinking like, okay, so is Blackpink gonna be alright, and is Blackpink doing well like before, or you know, did some kind of YG accident affect to Blackpink? Like, they were really curious about this, but you know, like, more than their expectations, like Blackpink just literally really, really did good job. So people were surprised and people were curious. I think they succeeded in terms of drawing the people's attention, and I think it was not a strategy though, but I think it was really good timing, I guess. And number three is about Hanbok. You know, in Blackpink music video, you can see a very beautiful costume that was transformed from Hanbok, and it was inspired, like obviously inspired by traditional Hanbok, which is Korean traditional clothes. When I saw the music video, I thought it was really, really beautiful, but it was really transformed a lot. So there were these arguments between Korean people, like, can they transform this traditional clothes into this much, even though there were so many complimentary comments among foreign fans. You know, they, foreign fans, like, were kind of surprised and shocked to see those beautiful costumes. So because when they think about Asian clothes or Asian costume, they easily think of kimono, which is Japanese traditional clothes, not Korean one. But you know, this clothes in Blackpink's music video, that was really, really beautiful, and that was Korean. So we were kind of proud, and foreign fans were really pleased to see that. And I'm also proud that, I mean, my people, like Korean people, have that beautiful clothes. But you know, there were these arguments like, oh, okay, can Blackpink transform this traditional clothes into this much? Like, they wear a top, which was like underwear back in like 500 years ago, and they transformed a lot in many ways, like, and that was quite different from traditional hanbok. But you know, actually the designer who made that hanbok, she explained how and why she transformed it, and actually she is in a process of doctorate degree for hanbok, and she researched it, and she did a lot of hard work on transforming that hanbok like from traditional version to this modern version. And she actually has a historical background and foundation for doing that. So she was on this TV show for interview, like why she did it like that. So that was kind of concluded. So people started to understand, and you know, it's 2020, so there's no harm to transform in a creative way, you know, as long as it can be loved by global people and as long as it doesn't lose its original identity. So I guess it was really beautiful. And that Hanbok store's name and Hanbok designer's name is Tanha Hanbok. And this is my research result. So if you are interested in Korean Hanbok, or if you want to buy some of those, then you can just visit here because she also has an online store. And this is not an advertisement. I have no connection with her. I'm just letting you guys know just in case. I was intended to translate Blackpink's lyrics, but you know, like right after Blackpink released their new song, like there were a hundred kinds of lyrics translation versions. So I guess I'd rather tell you guys like these background stories and surrounding stories around Blackpink and Blackpink's new song. Okay, so I'm gonna come back soon with South Korea's fun and interesting stories. So until then, bye for now.